in California. It's the site of tomorrow's final between Germany and Sweden. It's today's third place match venue for Canada and the United States. And a pleasant good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to sunny California. I'm JP Della Camera. The USA will not be playing in the final in this World Cup for many reasons. One of those reasons, Wendy Guevara-Palladino, is the fact that Germany last week was able to nullify the USA veterans on a collective basis.
That's right, JP. This U.S. team was defeated by a very talented German side. It has been a tough, tough week for this U.S. team, but especially for the veterans. In the big games, it is the youth that look to their leadership to get the job done, and they know collectively as a unit they didn't get it done. This game will be a true test of character for a handful of women, some of the most amazing women in sports, who are most likely playing in their last World Cup match.
And these USA veterans are going to be taking on a very young Canadian side, and Tony DeChico, Canada's young, big, and aggressive, especially up top.
Every team has struggled to deal with the strength, power, and resolve of the Canadian three front. Two-thirds of that three front, Sinclair and Latham, have been solid, but 16-year-old Kara Lang, in her first ever World Cup, has been nothing less than impressive. Here she is scoring the first goal, the lead goal, against Sweden. Kara Lang will look to improve her performance against the USA today.
At 16, she's part of Canada's present and also their future. As for the USA veterans, how do they respond today after last week's devastating loss versus Germany? Come back with us, and we'll find out together in the third place match.
Is it or is it not true that you kicked and pummeled the plaintiff in the plain view of over 60,000 witnesses?
It's true.
And what did you and your malicious co-conspirators do next?
We cheered.
As this poor, battered soul lay defenseless and deflated. You didn't tell me you cheered.
Bud Light, proud sponsor of the U.S. Women's National Team in the FIFA Women's World Cup.
We're toast.
Get into it.
Welcome aboard. Please turn off all unapproved electronic devices. The captain expects frequent turbulence, so please remain seated at all times. And we do anticipate a late arrival. Thank you.
The Hyundai Santa Fe, with America's best warranty. 10 years, 100,000 miles. When you upgrade your travel plans, you win. Hyundai is an official partner of the FIFA Women's World Cup.
Know what I like about Texas? Well, our heroes are bigger than life. We've got ones that ride away, ones that save the day, and somehow they always make it okay.
DQ's Crunchy Steak Finger Country Basket is only $2.99. It's four golden steak fingers, Texas toast, crispy fries, and the best cream gravy anywhere. Anytime you want the best treat around, try a 16-ounce Blizzard for $1.99.
That's what I like about Texas.
Because they'll never make a better tasting stamp glue, introducing Time Warner's Pay Express. The fast, easy way to pay your cable bill online. No stamps, no glue, no hassles. Just go to TWCHouston.com to learn more. Pay Express. We've got bill paying clicked.
ESPN2's coverage of the 2003 FIFA Women's World Cup is brought to you by Bud Light, official beer of the U.S. Women's National Soccer Team. Toshiba, proud to be supporting the FIFA Women's World Cup as official IT partner. Adidas, proud sponsor of FIFA Women's World Cup 2003. Own the ball and you own the game. Hyundai, when your car comes with America's best warranty, you win. Hyundai. And by Time Warner Cable. Now, anything's possible.
Welcome back, everyone. We're getting ready for this third place matchup between Canada and the United States. And how will the USA respond after the loss to Germany? For more on Team USA, here's Tisha Holt.
A very emotional week for the U.S. team, especially these veteran players.
They've taken most of the blame for the loss against Germany. People have said they're getting old, they're past their prime, they should move on. These players disagree, and today they have the opportunity to show everyone not only do they belong out on this field, but they are, and they have been for the past 15 years, the heartbeat of this U.S. team. Back upstairs.
Thank you, Tisha. We will see how they respond today. It was a fairly easy World Cup for the USA until they hit Germany. In fact, they weren't even giving up goals except for the one that Sweden got in Game 1, and then Germany took over. But a couple of those goals came late in the 90-minute-plus stage when the USA was pushing everybody forward, trying for the tying goal. Your referee from Australia, Tammy Ogston. I would think this would be a physical match with all that's at stake, and especially the way Canada does play the game. Canada in the red and white, USA in white with the blue shorts. We are underway from the Home Depot Center. Christine Latham on the far side. Broken up, and it's out of play immediately. Quick Canadian throw in. Latham goes down as that ball goes out of play again. Our USA starting lineup is being brought to you by Adidas.
And the U.S. will play in a 4-4-2, and in the back line, Christy Pierce returns to the starting lineup. Number 14, Joy Fawcett, was named to FIFA's top 11 team. She's played in every minute of every game for this U.S. team. She's the leader of the defense. In the midfield, Mia Hamm will get that attacking center midfield slot, flanked by Lillian Foudy with Box holding. And up top, the U.S. will have to do a better job of taking care of the ball around the 18-yard box, and Carlo and Wambach will try to make better decisions in that part of the field. Here's a ball into the box here. Defensively, the U.S. is well organized. Its serve is just a little bit long and goes over the end line.
That is where Charmaine Hooper can be very dangerous. She'll play at the back, but she will be going forward on set pieces like that. USA with Hamm collecting. Our Canada lineup is being brought to you by Hyundai.
We have Swiatek in goal. She's been very impressive. Can her aggressiveness get her in trouble? In defense, it's patched up again. They've got Kimco and Andrews starting for the first time in the outside. In the midfield, Matheson moves to the center. And up front, the strength, power of Latham Sinclair and Kara Lang is something the U.S. will have to deal with.
Look at the high pressure from the Canadians. Floated up towards Latham. Settle there. Kara Lang! What a good early chance for Canada. And they'll get a corner kick out of it.
And here's what the U.S. has to be conscious of. If balls bounce in their penalty area, the Canadians are going to use their power and strength. They're going to get a shot off. Kara Lang almost putting it on the frame. But that's a good confidence boost for Canada to get an early shot against the USA.
And once again, we're seeing Charmaine Hooper, as we did the other night, taking these corner kicks, not being at the other end of those.
She's so good in the box, JP. It's one of the things that I disagree with Evan Pelroot.
Hooper strikes it. It's up high. Scurry comes out. Two fists on the ball. But it's right up the middle and shot back wide. And the United States gets a break there. Through all that traffic, that ball could have found its way to the back of the net.
And we talked about Fawcett being the leader of the U.S. defense, but she got herself into some trouble here. And Tony, you mentioned the quickness and aggressiveness of that three front for Canada. They were all over this and really almost put the ball in the back of the net on a huge miscue by this U.S. defense.
That's how Canada's going to attack. They're going to put the U.S. defense under pressure. The U.S. has to possess the ball.
We'd like to thank Adidas and all of our sponsors for allowing us to bring you the FIFA Women's World Cup without interruption. As the USA plays it wide on the right side, Christy Pierce with a long run in Bibbin's spot. Heads up play by Pierce, who has good speed. Still the ball towards the end line. Canada trying to win it there. It's still free. It did not go out, and Canada will clear. But flank play we can expect, as Tony was mentioning before, with the Canadians trying two new players out there. Why not test the flanks?
Well, they do need to test the flanks. They're playing in a system of against a 4-3-3, so they need to use the flanks. But what I've seen already...
Well, ball played right through. There was Wambach.
That's one they want to connect on. That's one the U.S. wants to connect on. That's a goal that's a missed opportunity.
Redick going inside, and Swiatek has that.
You know, against Germany, the U.S. did everything very well except in the final 18, and that's an example of it right there. They've got to connect on those serves because early in the game, if you get a quick goal, it's really a different game, and I think against Germany we all agreed that if the U.S. had finished some of their early chances, it would have been a different match.
Now, what I've seen already is this Australian referee in Australian soccer is pretty physical. She's letting some things go. That may benefit the Canadians if this game becomes combative. Remember, the Canadians want this to be combative, direct. They don't want rhythm to the game. The U.S. needs to have possession, control, change of point, all kinds of time with the ball.
Shannon Box, who made the FIFA All-Star team, plays it over on the left. This long pass up the wing. This is Mia Hamm. Inside the box. The cross. And it's upstairs. Parlo had the opportunity, but it was deflected. It's a corner kick. Hamm will take it.
The mobility there of Mia Hamm is going to create problems for the Canadian defense, especially these flank defenders that are new in position.
Swiatek came out and changed her mind and nearly paid a price as the ball is deflected, knotted down to Christy Pearce, who puts it right back up. No flag. And then the Hamm cross got away off the left foot.
Mia Hamm's mobility has been very good out of that attacking center midfield slot. For the second time, you see her getting in, trying to serve a beautiful ball there, bending behind Hooper, who is committed, and Parlo just can't quite get on the end of it.
Timko actually did a pretty good job of competing with Parlo on that service because that was a great attack by the USA.
Canada looking for some possession in the midfield. That's not been one of their strengths, certainly, in this tournament. April Heinrichs with a winning record as a head coach. Coming up short in this tournament, thanks to Germany. So today, April Heinrichs and the team playing in a game they didn't think, I'm sure, that they would be playing in the third-place match. Nonan plays it long. Knotted down by Box for Foudy. Julie Foudy plays it up. Cindy Parlo. Pushed to the side by Wambach. Foudy attacks on the flank. Has some help there. Again, they push it wide to the right. This ball came across, but it was out of play. And a goal kick coming up for the Canadians as Pearce has been effective on those runs. On the Canadian side, Tony, a guy you coached against, Evan Pellerud.
Well, I call it the Evan Pellerud factor. He has instilled a winning mentality with the Canadians. You see it in every game they play now. They feel like they can compete and beat any team in the world.
Held up there on the far side. Here comes Canada with Sinclair. Part of that trio. No flag is up. Now it comes up on Lang, but the referee didn't see it, and the ball goes out, and now she's looking over to the referee's assistant, and will go with her decision. So no corner. It will be the USA goal kick.
That was a bit of a late flag. She was offside from the start, as you can see here. The flag didn't come up until the ball was played into her area, which is one of those questions that I always wonder who else was going to be playing that ball other than Lang.
Lang, a player to watch certainly today and for many years in a Canadian uniform. They're finding young players. That's something they weren't doing before Pellerud came, at least not as many.
I like this quick restart by the USA.
See if it leads to something. Wambach had a chance. Some end-to-end play early on in a game that both teams really want for different reasons.
This ball coming in here, Wambach's trying to connect on it. A nice serve. The U.S. is mixing it up. They're putting balls in the air, crossing the box. They're also trying to find seams. What they're trying to do in every opportunity is get the ball wide, and like you said, Tony, test these outside backs for Canada. They're not normally defenders. And then turn the corner on. And typically, Canada pushes players strong side, maybe floods it too much, and if the U.S. can get those serves back post, they should have some opportunities.
Now that ball by Kate Sobrero is the ball I think they need to avoid. They need to play the ball on the ground, look for service in the air when Parlo and Wambach are on the end of them in the penalty area, but not just as target players. Only when you have to clear the ball.
Box will play it back, and it's swung out by Sobrero. She and Redick have been trading places in many of these World Cup matches. Here's Lily, broken up. Coming back, Sinclair, looking for Latham. Those three always look for one another as well. They're not selfish players.
I still like that possession by the USA. It broke down in the midfield, but they were trying to possess the ball. They need to do more of that.
Canada's ball as they clear. Toss it in the air. Canada will send it back. No flag. Lang. And a bad bounce stopped her. Otherwise, she could have had a breakaway. Lang cutting inside. That's the teenager. She's not 17 years old for several more days, but looking like a veteran out there.
Certainly playing well beyond her years. She's tough, she's strong, she's athletic. I can't get that free kick out of my mind that she hit against Sweden, so she's impactful up top for Canada.
Good ball by Julie Foudy there. And good decision by Christine Lilly. The U.S. wants to possess the ball. Be patient with it.
Line, Cervero will clear it out. Still scoreless here, but USA could be down.
And as we mentioned, one of the key factors in this U.S. defense is Joy Fawcett. She comes over and helps Kat Reddick out after Kat Reddick stumbles here on the turf. It's Kate Cervero coming over, providing great pressure, and they're able to shut her down with a good 2v1 organization.
How about Carol Lang just out-muscling Reddick on that play?
That's tough to do, because Reddick is one of the strongest defenders this U.S. side has.
Going against the Canadians, we're in the 11th minute, scoreless, but it's been end-to-end action. USA obviously does not want to finish in fourth place. Their worst finish was in 95 when they went to third place, especially with these veterans closing out their World Cup careers. And for Canada, this is like a World Cup final. They've done well to get this far, but imagine if Canada could beat the United States, Tony, what that would do to their program.
Well, this game is for regional dominance, and this is very, very important. It's not just a third-place game. It's for regional dominance, and obviously the U.S. wants to be gold medalists in the Olympics next year, but to be world champions or Olympic champions, you got to be able to dominate your own region.
And lately, when these two sides have matched up, they've been very competitive against each other. In fact, in the Gold Cup final, the qualifications for the World Cup, the U.S. won it in a golden goal in overtime.
Lang again. And she took that shot, may have rushed it as it went wide. Wendy was talking about the series history. You know, it used to be lopsided, but not anymore. The Canadians are just getting better at this game. So, Tony, maybe the days of those earlier blowouts could be over, at least for the majority of the games.
One of Evan's qualities is he looks for athletes. So he doesn't have necessarily the best soccer players out there. Even a Carol Lang, she's not the cleanest player with the ball, but you can see that she's a great athlete. She's 16 years old. She's only going to get better.
USA will take it wide on the flank. They'll hold up play. The look. Pardo nods it down, but it's wide. Goal kick Canada.
Okay, here comes that serve. Cindy Pardo's on the end of it. She should be driving that towards that near post instead of flicking it on. I think if she drives it towards the near post, she's going to beat Swiatek on it.
Back the other way towards Swiatek, one of three goalkeepers that the Canadians brought here. And Swiatek did not come here as the number one, but she's ending up as number one, at least at the moment. Canada out shooting the USA in the early going.
The USA needs to use Swiatek's aggressiveness against her. Make sure their crosses are drawing her out to the point where she's coming for balls that she can't hold or maybe can't even get. Now she's pulled out of the goal. Now maybe the U.S. can knock in an easier goal than having to build and break down a pretty solid, patched up but solid Canadian defense.
Great point, Tony, because, you know, against Germany, that's what the U.S. didn't do well, and they continued to just pump up the confidence of Rottenberg, and as the match went on, she just got stronger and stronger. So you really can help a goalkeeper out with her confidence by not struggling to get the ball, not putting her under some strain to come out and find the serve.
Ham in front, Wambach and Parlow ran into each other. They're both down, as is a Canadian player. They got to stop play. I know it may be rough, Tony, in Australia, but you got to stop it. You got three people down there. And you never know, especially if it was a collision that involved the head. Three big players are in there. It looks like everybody's okay.
Shows the commitment of both teams.
Nice ball here by Ham again. She's serving some nice balls into the box. And both Wambach and Parlow are going strong after it in a huge collision there. You got to give them credit for going after it and having the desire to try and stick the ball in the back of the net. They're really trying to do a better job with their decisions inside the 18. On that last one, they got a little too ahead of themselves, maybe.
I think you're right, Randy. I think they're putting in some dangerous balls. I'm impressed with Timko. She went against those two big bodies of the USA and held her own and made sure there wasn't a shot on goal.
Ball is back to Sobrero. She'll go long for Wambach. Not a down. Very steady. Geralta Nonan is back to chase it. It's been a very stabilizing force in that Canadian back line.
Again, I'd like to see Kate Sobrero possess the ball in the midfield rather than just always or consistently look for target players up front.
Parlow bringing it back. Holding it. Foudy. To the right side it goes. Pierce cutting back. Foudy. That's broken up by the aggressive Canadians who will clear it upfield. The look is for Latham. Good idea to play it back and then look for something long. Flag comes up again a tad late, so it seems.
Yeah, that was actually a pretty easy call too. She was clearly offsides as the ball is played. And you're right, JP. I'm not sure what the delay is. The only reason I don't like delays is players play until the whistle is blown, and you hate to see somebody get injured when it's clearly an offside.
Ham trying to get through, broken up. It's out to Lily. Nice cut by the veteran, but then she was dispossessed, and it's cleared by Christina Kiss. Sobrero lets it go out for a USA throw-in here in the 16th minute.
Now the keys for Canada is they need to keep trying to dictate the style, this combative style.
Wambach, who likes that style herself, will take it up the left wing. No help close to her yet. Now she finds it, but it went past Ham. And Canada tried to clear it up, but they could not. Wambach, the cross. Dangerous clear up the middle. Matheson did well to relieve the pressure and find Christine Sinclair, who's got a lot of space and time. Sinclair tried the through ball, could have gone several more strides and kept possession. Canada still has possession. Right flank, it's Kara Lang. Headed away. Ham, an early ball over the top. Parlow trying to run onto it. That was played too slowly. Back to Switek. Canada nearly gave one up there.
I think that's just inexperience. Charmaine Hooper being a center back, when you're inside or near your penalty area, don't roll that ball back into the goalkeeper. There's not enough space. Play it out wide. Deal with the throw-in. Here comes that back pass. Parlow's all over it. A lot of those end up in the back of the net, and Canada was fortunate there.
Long ball towards Sinclair. Fawcett won that in the air for Shannon Box. Latham will hold. Cleared away to the right flank. Here's Pierce. Intended for Wambach. Out it goes. A USA throw in. To Shannon Box. Off the block. Here is Box. Lily trying to turn. Lays it off well. Pat Reddick. Reddick playing it up. Lily on the turn, slotting it through almost. Canada rejects that as well.
That's not bad for the USA. Where they're starting to lose the ball is right in front of Canada's penalty area. That's where you want to lose the ball in the final pass or the pass before the final pass.
Lang to the corner, sends it up, and Scurry touched that one out. It's a corner kick. Canada.
You can tell when Canada gets into the attacking third, they're very well organized. This ball is not pulled out, however. Brianna Scurry does go up and make a save to keep it from going in that upper corner, upper 90. But again, like the U.S. was having trouble against Germany pulling the serves out, Canada's having trouble pulling them out away from Scurry.
Canada's second corner kick of the match. And Hooper will take another. Minute scoreless at this point as Hooper strikes. Scurry got a piece and got the rest as it came down in traffic.
Interesting save there by Brianna Scurry. Ball's flighted in. She fights through. She gets a touch to it, but her athleticism gets her up so much quicker than the next player.
Fights was the key word there. Swiatek sends it over and will lose possession for the Canadians. Here's Lily. 1v1, left sideline. Trying to get around Christina Kiss. Nice tackle in the end, but it will result in a corner kick.
And that's what the U.S. wants to do. They want to change the point of attack using possession. And once they can match up a Christine Lilly 1v1 on an inexperienced player, she will eventually beat her, get around the area, and find somebody inside.
No corner kick. Referee spotted the foul instead. So it's a free kick here for the USA with Ham and Lilly around the ball. Three in the wall for Canada. Is ready. It's all hers. Going up, and that one is too high. Box was at the back post.
They were going for Box on that. Box would redirect that back into the center, so that was by design, just overhit by Mia.
Tomorrow night on ESPN, it's Sunday Night Football as the 49ers battle the Seahawks from Seahawks Stadium. Catch all the day's highlights with NFL Primetime presented by Miller Lite at 7:30. 21st minute, still a scoreless one. This has become quite the rivalry now, Canada and the United States. It wasn't years ago because of the USA's dominance, but now it is.
So far, the U.S. has done a really good job, as Tony keeps pointing out, trying to possess the ball and being patient. And they're also trying to get that ball in around behind, out wide, and like Lily did, turn the corner on her player and get in for a serve. So they're executing that fairly well.
Yeah, Julie Foudy needed there, instead of to play that into that tight space where the defense was organized, come back to Box, find Lily on the opposite side.
USA attacking, broken up by Hooper. That looked like a little more than shoulder to shoulder. Charmaine plays him rough.
I'm not sure if it's a throw-in or a free kick. We'll get a sense of how this Australian referee is going to be calling this.
Well, whether she's at the back, Tony, or up top, she only knows one way to play. And it was a free kick, USA, on the short one. Drifted across. Sinclair, and that's not a good clear. Wambach trying to shield and turn. Couldn't get it. Lily fires! A goal for Lily!
Continues to try and battle. The ball bounces out to Lily, who is patiently waiting, and she just absolutely rips it from the top of the box. This is where she loves to get the ball. Look at this ball. Back across the face of the goal. There's no way Swiatek's going to get on the other end of it. Just rips it. That's the ball that Christine Lily loves.
Did it remind you, Wendy, of game one against Sweden?
It did, absolutely.
Same kind of shot off the left foot from pretty much the same area. Canada now trails as Lang tries to play it up off a Fawcett deflection. It goes back to Scurry, Lily's second goal of this World Cup and her seventh career World Cup goal.
Remember, that U.S. goal was started off of a set piece, a quick restart out on the right side by Hammond Foudy.
I think the first goal in this game is critical. When Canada gets the first goal, they sit back, they go into a 4-5-1 or a 4-4-2, they create a block of 8 or 9, and they're difficult to penetrate. Now they've got to come out and play a little bit.
Long ball from Canada. Again, they look for Lang. Back to Scurry. And Brianna settles it down.
We're having quite a matchup out here with Redick and Lang. I mean, this is a physical matchup. Redick is physical. Lang, we know, plays with tremendous strength and power for a young 16-year-old. So this is an interesting matchup we can watch.
24th minute. USA leading Canada 1-0. On a Lily goal. Touched out last by Wambach. Canada will have a throw in. Pride at stake for these USA veterans. So when their leadership and their age, I guess Wendy was questioned, they wanted to come out strong.
Well, that's what Tisha said at the open of the show, and I agree with her. I mean, these players shouldn't be written off because of that Germany game. Certainly they know as a collective group they didn't show up and get the job done. They've been analyzing and overanalyzing and trying to figure out what they could do. But as Julie Foudy said, you can't rewind that game. We've got to go out here and show what we're made of and get this job done against Canada.
You know, in effect, all the criticism of the U.S. kind of takes away how great the German side was, and we'll see them tomorrow against Sweden. Here's Foudy on the attack for the USA. They don't sit back when they have a lead, as Tony mentioned, the Canadians would do, and so would other teams. Played up by Matheson. And again, those strong players up front. Latham looks for Sinclair, well read. Cleared by Sobrero, right side, Foudy. Off the head of Parlo. Hooper's coming back. Nods it down. That was, like Tony was saying before, she's not used to playing there, so she's not used to those touches back there. That's another awkward touch back to goal.
What she should remember is how she likes it as a front runner. She loves being on the other end of those balls if a defender's trying to play that back. She's got to do a better job of clearing them.
She's keeping it exciting back there.
There's Rennick playing it all the way back. Of course, Hooper was brought back to defense because of all their injury problems. It's not a tactical move, but they're going with what they feel is their best lineup here, and it means Charmaine's playing on defense.
And it was Abby Wambach was the attacker for the U.S. that was providing so much pressure there. Just showing all the effort that she's putting into this match.
USA with the ball in the lead in the 26th minute. Christine Lilly with a goal. She gets set for the throw-in. Wambach coming towards the ball with three Canadians there. She took care of one and gets called for the foul. Christina Kiss is up and limping. Downstairs we go to Tisha Hoke for an update on Team USA. Tish.
Coach Palladino came up to me right before kickoff and said, I got three words for you. Attack the flanks. And they've done a tremendous job doing that. I think Christy Pierce's bread and butter is getting up and down that line. And you'll see Christine Lilly getting in all day long, I think, on this left side. You know, the next piece of that puzzle is, will they get a finish on some of these? Which, you know, they're getting close. But, you know, that's their ultimate goal here.
Thanks, Tish, as the USA wins that ball in the air. And before they can go up the flank, Lilly was detained.
The other person that's getting out on the flank, and I really like this run, is Mia Hamm from that holding position behind the two front runners. She's making that run out into the flank, and that's a difficult run for the Canadian defense to track, especially these two new defenders that are playing out wide, Timko and Andrews.
Nonan came over on that side as Andrews went towards the inside that time. Another foul is going to be called. It's against the USA. Canada with a free kick from long distance.
And this is something that Canada wants to do. They want to create set pieces. They want to get their big bodies in there. Of course, they're going to... Finally, Evan Pellerud pointed to Charmaine to get into the penalty area. So maybe he's listening to our broadcast up here. I'm not sure. But that's where she needs to be, because she has a knack to pick up loose balls in the penalty area and shoot them on goal.
Come on, Nikki!
Christina Kiss just looked back at Evan Pellerud for some instruction on this before taking it. Now she puts it up into the middle. Deflected wide. Long run on that side. Andrews collected it. Canada will keep it alive and send it back towards Scurry. Bryan didn't get there. It hit off the post. USA dodged one, and Scurry is hurt. Lang was on that side and nearly knocked it in. And the USA team, first, before the training staff can get out there, is over there in a hurry.
Here's the replay. It's a far side ball. Lang is crashing on it. She gets a touch to it, hits off the post. I'm not sure if she got a piece of Bry Scurry or... Yes. Obviously, there was a collision there. And let's see how serious that is. Obviously, Mullenix is up and warming up already.
Can Can we believe this? Kara Lang with six shots already in the game. I mean, there were games where the Canadian team didn't get six shots. That's what I recall they had as a team against Sweden, six.
Okay, on this play, the ball went wide. Now it's swung back into the far post. Kara Lang is coming hard for it. She slides in. The ball hits the post, but as she slides through, she gets Brianna Scurry. I don't think it's intentional. We'll have to see how serious this injury is.
You mentioned Lang's size, though, at 5'11 and coming strong. And Scurry couldn't really brace for it. Mullenix is warming up in the 30th minute. Mullenix and Kuechly are the only two USA players yet to play a minute in this World Cup. Scurry's been so durable for the United States, and we've seen her down before but bounce back up. In fact, we did a game recently, Wendy, where she did come out, but I think that was more of a precaution in one of the games that was played out on the West Coast.
Well, she's had this recurring problem with her knee where she actually referred to it as a bit of a stinger, and she actually had to come out of that match. And I know the medical staff was a little worried because if this happened in a World Cup...
Here's some of the plays she's had to make. She's had to get up and put a ball over the top of the crossbar and awkward. She's had to fight through. She wasn't happy with that, as you can see. She's had to come hard to the near post to deny a goal there and take a hit. She's already been more active than Swiatek in some goalkeeping.
Well, you know she's a competitor and she'd love to continue. Here in the 31st minute. Meanwhile, Mullenix continues to be up on the sideline. She's still feeling it. Brianna Scurry, one of the most popular players to ever play for Team USA. Mm-hmm. Number one goalkeeper for many years, from 94 to 99, until she lost that job and then reclaimed it.
Well, my guess here is she's going to try to play, and if it's something that's really troubling her, then Coach Heinrichs will make a change. But I know Bryce Curry. I mean, the last thing she wants to do is come out of the game.
At the same time, Tony, she's a professional, and she knows if it's going to hurt her team for her to be out there, I think that she'll also make that decision as well.
Well, they are giving her a lot of time to figure this one out. They're not as patient in the men's game. She's going to stay. And the person leading the cheers on the sideline was Suri Mullenix for scoring.
She has been such a great supporter for Brianna Scurry this whole World Cup. It's tough being a reserve goalkeeper, and normally in a big championship event, the goalkeeper is going to play in all the matches if they can. They don't usually split that role up. And hats off to Suri Mullenix for her positive attitude.
Throw in for the USA, who lead 1-0. 33rd minute here. Lily with the only goal of the match. This is the third place game. Tomorrow, it's the final. Germany and Sweden. Neither of whom have ever won a World Cup. Here is Lang. Throw in for the USA. Near sideline. Towards Wambach. One in the air by Andrews, who had some size back there. Not experienced, but she's 5'11". USA still leading, but the scoring chances have been pretty much equal. And we gave you a number before. Wendy, Kara Lang with six shots.
Yeah, Tony mentioned her at the top of the show, and she's a force to be reckoned with. Just a youngster who probably doesn't even know any better, but physically she can compete very well, and she's very tactical, technically organized. She's really making runs at the edge of the restraining line.
And this call is going the other way. Home fans don't agree. Most of whom are supporting the USA, although there are plenty of Canadian fans in attendance today in this third-place match.
Okay, here's this contact. There's contact. I think
Abby kind of embellishes it. I actually agree with the call here by the Australian referee that there was no foul play on, and I think Cannon ended up with a throw-in.
Saw Hooper saying it was a dive. Back on the left side, Lily.
Hooper knows a dive when she sees one.
Here's Ham. Trying to go wide, and she does on Andrews. Nice cut back. Here's the cross. Chested down rather dangerously in the box, but Hooper was able to clear. Here's Box on it. Box will hold and play wide for Pierce, who continues to push up. Wambach chested it down as a pass. Well done for Lily. The fake. Wider to Ham. Mia went inside and just missing the head of Cindy Parlow. I think at the last second, Ham decided instead of going for goal, there was Parlow. There's Sinclair running at the heart of the USA defense. Try to float that one in. That's how you head a ball back to goal.
And that's twice that Shannon Box has been caught on the wrong side of the ball and allowed a counterattack. So she needs to support the attack, but she's got to make sure that they can't break out that quickly.
And although Canada's in a three-front, that's Sinclair that's starting that counterattack. She's coming back and fighting for the ball in that area that Shannon Box is playing out of.
Sobrero up as high as she's been here today so far. On the run of play, anyway. Cleared by Hooper. They keep looking for that big player, and they find her in Lang. Runs over and through Reddick, and still has possession. Latham, back for Lang. Quick low shot. Not bad. Got to be impressed with these Canadian forwards.
You got to be impressed with the 16-year-old. I mean, how good is she going to be when she's, you know, 20? Look at her fight through Reddick. Not only does she quit there, she wins the ball, she plays it up, she gets it back from Latham, and she drives a good shot on goal that requires a good save by Brianna Scurry.
Here's Box. Wendy, I'm not comparing Lang to anyone like a Mia Hamm, but Mia started on the USA team at 15. I mean, are we seeing a special player here at this age?
Oh, I think we are for sure. I mean, she is a much different player than Mia Hamm. She obviously is not as explosive as Hamm, but she's just a workhorse, and she uses her strength to get herself in positions to cause a lot of havoc for the defense, and also she's getting some good shots off.
Charmaine Hooper's record for goals for Canada at some point would be in jeopardy with one of these three up top. The foul is called on the Canadians, Matheson. And the USA will have a free kick.
Evan Pellerud is being talked to by the fourth official, who's not very happy with that call. Of course, no one wants to allow set pieces to the U.S.
Ham floats that one up. There was a slip inside the box there by Abby Wambach. It'll roll out harmlessly for a goal kick for Switek. 37th minute, a Lily goal. All that's separating, really, these two teams in the scoreboard.
What a goal that was. I mean, that was just a cracker. As Wendy said, it was just driven into the upper corner. There's no question on that one.
It was vintage Christine Lilly. Sinclair up to Latham. Latham strong too. Right through to Sinclair. Breasting in and a goal for Canada. Tied at one.
Okay, Latham went against her teammate from the San Diego Spirit. Joy Fawcett beat her. Gets the ball into Sinclair, and Sinclair is the most clinical finisher of the Canadian front line. She got that opportunity, she just puts it away. Brianna Scurry had no chance on it.
And to take it one step further, it was actually Sinclair who started the pass and served it into Latham, continued to run through the U.S. defense and got it back.
So right now, Wendy, what we're seeing is both attacks are stretching the other team's defenses. Whichever defense kind of gets it together first here is going to win this game.
Wambach towards the end line. She got knocked down and gets the call.
Another look at the goal. Shannon Box trying to recover there, but she can't. There's the through ball to Sinclair. Beautiful run again. Sinclair was the player who started it deep in the midfield. Very tactical play on her part.
Hamill have a free kick. The eyes of a goal scorer. Drives it across. Headed wide by Box.
That's a good ball. And you can see where Swiatek wants to come for every ball. And she's getting caught coming for some balls that she can't get. Here's the goal again by Canada. Great through ball. Sinclair slots it into the corner.
Sinclair's strike rate, this is her 56th game and 43rd goal. So she's already on her way to breaking Hooper's records. Back the other way, knotted down again dangerously to Switek. They may talk about that at halftime.
Well, that one's a little bit more conventional. The first two were
still scary, though. 40th minute, a 1-1 game. This already beats the third-place match from 99 when it was Brazil and Norway 0-0 decided on penalty kicks.
You know, and that goal that Canada scored, in my opinion, was not against the run of the play. The last 5 or 10 minutes, Canada really was settling the ball down and putting the U.S. team under a lot of pressure. So, in my opinion, they took advantage of the run of the play going their way.
Free kick for the USA. In years past, a 1-0 USA lead would have resulted in maybe 2-3 goals rather quickly. Instead, the Canadians fight back and they get the tying goal.
Good point, JP. I mean, right now, the U.S. defense has not looked that secure. And I think it's just from the strength and power of the Canadians.
Nonan using some strength of her own. Up for Lang. Tackled away by Box, and Lang almost went through that tackle as well. Here's Redding. Switching.
We've seen this before where Sobrero starts central and ends up outside, and Redick starts outside and ends up central. It's something the U.S. team has done in some earlier games.
And I think one of the reasons they might be moving Redick inside is just for that physical battle in the center of the defense.
Canada's done the same, switching Andrews and Nonan. Andrews was supposed to play out wide. Nonan has drifted out there. Ball knocked out. The USA will have it. Tomorrow we'll crown a champion. Will it be Hanna Lundberg's team, Sweden, or will it be Germany? It's Germany versus Sweden in the final. Neither of these teams have ever won a Women's World Cup. Of course, the Germans have done quite well on the men's side and even made it to the last final.
We're seeing Tiffany Milbert warm up on the sideline. I wonder if there's a sub coming here in the first half.
42nd minute.
Seems to be a little late.
Tackle out. Goal kick. Milbert being spoken to by April Heinrichs. Getting ready to come in.
There's two strategies here. Coach Heinrichs might want to get her into the game just to get her a couple minutes here in the first half, so when she starts the second half, there's no orientation period required. Or there could be an injury out there where they need to pull a player out.
It's going to be interesting to see what they do if there's no injury. Is it a Parlo or a Wambach or someone like that that comes out? We'll wait and see. I think it's Parlo's number they've got up. Yes, it is. So Cindy Parlow's day is done, and Tiffany Milbert will be coming on, and Parlow gets a well-deserved ovation. A couple of goals for Parlow in this World Cup. And Milbert comes on. She's played in every game as a sub, trying to recapture some of those great games we've seen her play in the last couple of years. This year's been a tough year for Tiffany.
What Tiffany Milbert will give them is she will run at the restraining line. She will run to get in behind the fences. And if she gets matched up one versus one, it's going to be a problem for Canada.
Parlow's being spoken to. Maybe there is an injury, who knows? But it could have been a tactical reason as well. But she is out. USA have two subs left if they want them.
Let's not forget, she went down real hard in the penalty box earlier in this half.
Canada will clear a 1-1 game in the third place match.
Now, I like that by Christy Pierce. Latham is sprinting at her. She cuts the ball back and forces her to stop her run. What you want to do to the Canadian front runners is stop them from sprinting, and by possession, you can do that. Because when they zero in on a ball and they're sprinting at it, they're tough to deal with.
44th minute. Quick throw in. Wambach let it go. Here's Milbert. Tried the through ball for Mia Hamm. Not a bad idea. Just wasn't executed well. Bowdy will hold. intercepted by Timko. Look at her go. She's played in every minute of every game in this World Cup, but that pass was picked off.
So the U.S. has to be careful here because Pierce is committing herself. Again, she's completely committed into the attack there. Now the U.S. defense has two, sometimes three players to deal with on a counterattack, and Canada is very good at a counterattack.
We've got an update on Cindy Parlow. Let's go to the sideline and Tisha Hogue. Tish, what do you have?
Apparently Cindy Parlow is still shaken up from that collision she had. Hold on.
I was going to let you call it. Swiatek stops it. You can finish.
Apparently she's still shooken up from the collision she had with Womack and one of the other Canadian players. There, possibly maybe a concussion. They're checking her out pretty good here, so hopefully she'll be all right.
Anytime. Thanks, Tish. Anytime you hear that word, concussion or head injury or anything like that, you got to sit out a player. Here is Box. Right side, Pierce. Bowdy. Wambach. The touchback for Fawcett. We're in the final minute. We'll see what they do for stoppage time. Actually, there should be some. With Scurry going down for a while at the other end. Lilly has it knocked out. Throw in. USA. We're in stoppage time now. And they are going to put 4 minutes up, so that's not a surprise. Lang and Sobrero, no give on either player.
Lang doesn't know the word of give.
Here's Reddick. As the USA starts it up quick. We're in stoppage time. This is the most stoppage time we've seen in any of the World Cup games we've done this year, but again, it's justified. The pass up for Ham. Nice reach in by Hooper.
You know, on that last restart, I think it was a good idea for Sobrero to restart it quickly, but I would like to see Kat Reddick take a touch and go ahead and rip it from there. We've seen her hit shots from there. She's very dangerous.
We saw Kara Lang score a goal against a very good Swedish goalkeeper doing the same thing. So it's something that's always got to be considered, Wendy. Good point.
Knocked out by Lilly. And it'll be a throw-in for Canada. Nonan. This one is broken up. Here's Ham. Milbert couldn't get through. Hooper steps it away. Good footwork from Hooper. Then she loses. Wombach, quick turnover there to Milbert. Then to Lilly. Box to the right. We'll play it wide for Foudy. Pierce joins in the attack. Fly. Foudy holds. Ham's touchback. Box fakes, right-footed shot. It took too long to develop, but now the USA must come back. Pierce is caught upfield.
Pierce is caught upfield, and Box is caught upfield. Well played there by Kat Reddick. Canada had a great chance for a counterattack there.
They should have had a little more patience, too. Canada supported on that run.
Yep. Canada was a little impatient with their counterattack and gave the ball away. I would have liked to see Julie Foudy rip that coming across the 18 there, left-footed.
Julie Foudy will play it in deep. Here's the cross. Flicked up. Lilly brought it down. Fakes on the right foot. Wanted a turn, and Hooper read it well. And then the foul on Lilly. I should say on Nonan. Charlton Nonan making that stop.
You know, we mentioned Nonan's name on occasion. The truth is she's been the glue of the defense.
Yeah, very
been
good.
Patched up defense since day one. Charlton Nonan has been the one player that has kept it together and has done a remarkable job in the center of defense.
Long ball play by Canada. Scurry coming off the line, and Ryan will hold on. Third minute of stoppage time here. 1-1. Coming up at halftime, Mia Hamm's legacy and a first half analysis. Rob Stone and Heather Mitz are somewhere in this beautiful new stadium. Seated comfortably, I hope. Here is the U.S. with Ham. Touchback. Awkward touch there. Foudy trying to win that ball on the right. Now it's Latham. Long for Lang. One against three. Doesn't matter to her. She's still after that with aggressive play. And now Latham joins. Well done to play it back and push some numbers forward. Here's Canada. looking more experienced than the average age and average caps shows them to be, Wendy.
You know, I'm sitting up here and I'm watching this counterattack by Canada. They seem to be a little bit fatigued because I think have had some great opportunities. The U.S. defensive players are committing. Again, Shannon Box caught way up. This U.S. defense a little bit out of sync here, and Canada's not taking the best advantage of it.
Well, I think fatigue maybe because the U.S. is doing a pretty good job. They can do a better job, a pretty good job of possession. That's forcing Canada to chase the ball. And that's where you fatigue. You see Kara Lang's hands on her knees. She's chasing hard. And that last attack wasn't a bad attack. It was a ball dummied through. But the U.S. needs to keep possession.
What a first half we've had. And I think there'll be some interesting locker room conversations on both sides. Canada came back and tied the match up on a nice goal from Sinclair. Lillian scored first. 1-1 is the score at halftime. ABC and ESPN, the official broadcast partners of the FIFA World Cup and Major League Soccer.
For the journalists who are covering the world's most challenging sporting event for women, Toshiba is supplying PCs to the tournament organizing committee to help them report the news while it's hot. Toshiba, proud to be supporting the FIFA Women's World Cup as official IT partner. Toshiba.
Your printing demand soared to tens of thousands of pages a day, and you handled it. But your question was, how well? So you embarked on a search until you found it. A better printing solution from Canon. One that brings a new standard to the production environment. Now, life is good. Yes, it's very good indeed.
Scary.
Yeah, and I bet they didn't have that insurance back then. What?
Aflac.
It gives your mommy money if she's sick and can't work.
What does?
Aflac.
Pay attention.
To what?
Aflac!
Aflac. Ask about it at work.
Aflac!
This Tuesday on Playmakers.
The EA offered a deal.
Accept the deal. I will reinstate your effective immediately.
You should tell them to shove it.
Playmakers, the hit series, continues Tuesday, 9 p.m. on ESPN. Preceded by last week's episode at 8.
We engineered a material behind the dash called Quiet Steel. Only the new Ford F-150 has it. Which means it's the only truck to deliver this. The sound of quality. The sound of the quietest pickup, period. Only this truck earned the right to be the next F-150. If you haven't looked at Ford lately, look again.
This is a public notice. Westside Chevrolet in Katy is in a GM sales contest and should receive tens of thousands of dollars from the manufacturer, which could be passed on to you. Save $8,500 on new 2003 Westside Chevy Silverado Z71 4x4 extended cabs and save $9,500 on new 2003 Westside Chevy Suburbans, as this is a no-brainer sales event with the money Westside will save you now through October 31st at Westside Chevrolet in Katy.
Welcome to the Canon Halftime Report, brought to you by Canon. With thousands of products and one simple idea, giving people know-how. Canon know-how.
And welcome back to the Home Depot Center and the Canon Halftime Report. I'm Rob Stone. Her days are filled with the shrieks and screams of Mia Mia from the Ponytail Hooligans. She has been thrust into the media spotlight, and she is without question the face of women's soccer on this planet. She is Mia Hamm, the reluctant icon. She is the world's all-time leading goal scorer, but the legacy of Mia Hamm is greater than the sum of her points.
Mia has been the most unbelievable ambassador for soccer. You couldn't have asked for anybody more humble, anybody more dedicated, anybody more passionate about not only improving as an individual, but being a part of a team.
for those who are close to the team and her teammates, I think her legacy will be how selfless she's been. There were so many opportunities where she could have said, I'll take the spotlight, but she never would. You know, sometimes we'd have to literally shove her into it and say, you deserve this, get out there.
I feel very, very grateful for her and what she's done. I mean, I appreciate 100% the burden that she's had to carry with that title of being, you know, the face of women's soccer.
She's an incredible speaker, and the impact that she has on people is amazing, but she doesn't let that go to her head. Nothing at all goes to her head.
I have an opportunity to make a difference, to help people out, to give young girls the opportunity to feel better about themselves.
One of the ways she helps others is through the Mia Hamm Foundation.
The Mia Hamm Foundation started in memory of my brother, who was actually going through a bone marrow transplant and subsequently passed away after complications. The foundation has two facets. One is to help families going through bone marrow transplants. And then the other one is we give funds to programs that are out there to encourage and empower girls in sports.
Got to make her proud because she's done something I think no other female athlete really has done. I think she's made a big impact in women's soccer, but in sports in general.
When I leave this game, they said there's a player that loved what I did every single day, even the days where we all complain about it. It's some of those days are what makes it so special.
Mia's legacy unquestioned, and it has affected and touched so many people, including yourself, Heather Mintz.
Definitely. Like we said, Mia Hamm is the face of women's soccer. Growing up, she was the one player that I looked up to. 3 years ago, I began playing with her and against her. You have to admire Mia for every time she steps on the field, her hard work, her determination, and as a player, you look up to her. You only hope to bring that to your game.
And you also have to realize how much she does not like being in the spotlight. She would much rather push Julie Foudy or Brandi Chastain in it and let them talk. It's not a role that she relishes, but it's one that has certainly been thrust upon her. I want to remind you that throughout the FIFA Women's World Cup 2003, Adidas will be giving away an official game ball from every single contest for your chance to win. Log on to adidas.com/ball and enter. Time for your Aflac trivia question. Which current U.S. player made her Women's World Cup debut as a sub for now head coach April Heinrichs?
From Enterprise, because having the right car or truck makes all the difference. Sweetheart, your honey-do list just got a little bit longer. Sorry.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Now this is big.
Now's the best time to buy wireless phones and accessories during the big, big sale at Radio Shack.
It's so big, it's
the LG VX6000 camera phone. Take, send, and personalize pictures. Just $149.99 after a $50 Radio Shack mail-in rebate.
It doesn't get any bigger than this.
The big, big sale. Now at Radio Shack. You've got questions, we've got answers.
I got a question for the folks at Radio Shack. Who's in charge of spelling around here?
Driver name it best luxury SUV for 2003? Well, there's this. 4X Motion all-wheel drive.
Beautiful.
Touareg, the Volkswagen that does what other Volkswagens don't.
years of photography experience. Legendary optics. Canon PowerShot digital cameras. Now with the Digic chip for beautiful photographs that happen to be digital. Digital revolutionized photography. We revolutionized digital.
Swim class, $60. Hockey camp, $340. Driving lessons, $250. Being able to let go. Being able to let go. Priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For parents everywhere, there's MasterCard.
Why do I rent from Enterprise? Because having the right car or truck makes all the difference. Sweetheart, your honey-do list just got a little bit longer. Sorry.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Most of these drivers have the same training, the same experience. So what separates one from the rest? Sometimes 12/1000ths of a second. The Chevy 500. Sunday at 3:30 Eastern on ESPN.
Getting a romantics cover on the big show. Welcome back to the Cannon Halftime Report. Heather Mitz, Rob Stone. You know, teams usually build their strength right up the middle of the field, but out wide is usually where they get their success, and you're seeing it today for the U.S.
Well, with this Canada team, they have some injuries, so it allows for a little bit inexperience in the back, which allows this key thing for the U.S. team is to attack down the flanks. We've seen them doing it so many times in this game. We see Mia Hamm, Chrissy Pierce, Christine Lilly getting in. They're beating players 1v1, getting end line and serving that ball across, and they've been so dangerous in this game so far. They'll have to continue to do that in the second half.
Mia's been a threat wide on both sides, left and right. You get the feeling she's got another assist in her bag. Time to wrap up your Aflac trivia question, and the question was, which U.S. World Cup player made her Women's World Cup debut, coming on as a sub for April Heinrichs? You got to go back to November of 91 when the U.S. took on Brazil, and Brandi Chastain, who is not available today due to that injury, came on. Christine Lilly in the 22nd minute. There is some nasty swerve on this rocket, folks. Her 93rd career goal. We're tied at ones at the break.
Hey, if we get hurt,
Whoa.
Good thing we got that insurance.
What's that? What'd you say?
Pays you cash if you can't work.
Before that, Zach.
I said I'm glad we got that insurance.
Not that.
Aflac.
Ask about it at work.
It's the bottom of the ninth, 4-3, two on, two out, with the entire season in the balance.
Just hang in there.
Games don't come any bigger.
And this one is going right down the wire.
The pitch.
Go.
He got a hold of it. It's gone!
The Hyundai Sonata with America's best warranty. 10 years, 100,000 miles. When you don't miss a thing, you win. Hyundai is an official partner of the FIFA Women's World Cup.
Tammy's here.
Not too late.
I know. Hey.
Got everything you need?
Yeah.
Just checking.
Meet Jay, one of the hosts of Cold Pizza, the new morning show on ESPN2. Jay gets to talk sports and hang around with three beautiful women. Tough gig. Join Jay, Kit, Thea, and Leslie starting Monday, October 20th at 7 a.m. Cold Pizza is a morning show with everything.
When your life is in fast forward, stop time with Time Warner Digital Cable for the time of your life. Get two great connections with one great back-to-school special. With Digital Cable, choose from hundreds of channels and no waiting at the video store. With Roadrunner High Speed Online, you're always connected. You can download photos and videos up to 50 times faster than dial-up.
Call today and receive a free upgrade to Digital Cable and Roadrunner High Speed Online. Add HBO and receive 14 channels.
This is it, Houston. Your last chance to pay zero initiation and join the all-new Inwood Forest Country Club. Amenities include free range balls and use of the practice facilities. gourmet dining, a fabulous members-only grill, and first-class locker rooms for the ladies and gents. This opportunity will never be repeated. From now to October 31st, you can join Inwood Forest Country Club free.
Call 281-448-0223. Schedule a tour.
ESPN2's coverage of the 2003 FIFA Women's World Cup is brought to you by MasterCard. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard. Toshiba, proud to be supporting the FIFA Women's World Cup as official IT partner. Adidas, proud sponsor of FIFA Women's World Cup 2003. Own the ball and you own the game. Hyundai, when your car comes with America's best warranty, you win. Hyundai. And by Time Warner Cable. Now, anything's possible.
Welcome back, everyone. We've got a good one in this third place matchup. Tied at one, the United States versus Canada. Here are the highlights in the first 45 minutes of play.
And the U.S. got on the scoreboard first in this match with a beautiful ball out here. Look at this shot by Christine Lilly. That ball cannot be any better hit. And then Canada gets a chance here, but it's Brianna Scurry that goes down. And actually, 4 minutes of extra time was added to the end of the first half as they tended to Brianna Scurry.
Here's the Canadian goal. Latham beats Joy Fawcett, gets the ball to Sinclair. Sinclair slots it past Brianna Scurry.
Teams huddling up, getting ready to come out and start the second half. Looking at the shots on goal, the Canadians had the edge there. Slightly more corners. Possession, we expected the USA to do better, which they did. And the foul count, believe me, it could have been a lot more than 15. A lot of it, as our guys up here mentioned, was let go in the first half of play. And Tony, you've been in the locker room on both sides. What are they talking about at halftime?
Well, the game is still in the balance. If I'm April Heinrichs, I'm saying our defense has to be better. We need to cover for each other. These players are going to attack the ball. They're going to attack you. There's going to be ball sprung free, and there better be another American player standing there to clear it out. Because I thought that actually both attacking teams dominated the defenses, but the Canadian defense dominated the U.S. defense more than they should have.
How about Canada quickly? Canadian locker room.
Well, in the Canadian locker room, they need to look to counterattack as they did. They need to make better choices on their counterattacks, and they need to do some of the same things they were doing, fighting for every loose ball, create an opportunity, and when you create an opportunity, put it on goal, try to sneak another goal. Remember, the team, if they can get the lead, they're going to be very dangerous because they will bunker with a block of eight or a block of nine in a 4-5-1 or a 4-4-2.
We saw them do that against Sweden, trying to hold on to that 1-0 lead, and it ended up coming back, and Sweden was very patient, was able to work through it and won that game 2-1, but only until the last 12 minutes of the match.
Right, and they did do it against China and held China scoreless.
Lily's after this ball, but it's cleared by Christina Kiss. If you're just joining us, it's USA in white and blue, Canada in red and white. 1-1, Lily and Sinclair are the goal scorers in this one. Two quality goals. Kara Lang has been the story, though. Canada had 9 first-half shots. She alone had 7 of them.
This halftime couldn't have come at a better time for players like her and the other two front-runners because they were getting very fatigued, weren't making the best of their counterattacks in the end of the first half.
Sobrero trying to defend as this ball goes out. It's a goal kick. We'd like to thank Bud Light and all of our sponsors for allowing us to bring you the FIFA Women's World Cup without interruption.
Here's where I think the U.S., Wendy, can do a better job with their back four, even though they're playing against a three front, possess the ball. Make the Canadian front runners chase the ball on defense so they have less energy to attack it offensively.
Well, and that's one of the reasons the front runners for Canada were so fatigued at the end of that first half, is because they were chasing it, but the U.S. can do even a better job of that.
Wambach is down on the field after a collision. It might have been knee to knee.
I think she got the wind knocked out of her. She had a pretty good collision there with Charmaine Hooper, and I think it's just the wind knocked out of her.
Collisions with Hooper could do that. Let's see.
Here's that collision.
Oh, yeah.
She's holding her solar plexus, which would indicate the wind being knocked out of her, but she's tough.
Yeah. First time we've used that phrase, Tony, on the air in this World Cup. Solar plexus, is that what you said?
Well, I want to be pharmaceutical along with...
Want to make sure we get it right. In the 48th minute, contact initiated 3 times, I guess, today, and contact received. You know, she's led this World Cup in fouls suffered, the most fouled player in this World Cup, Abby Wambach. So teams have keyed on her, knowing that they have to play her physical. They've been called for those fouls. This ball flicked the other way and let go at the near sideline by Christy Pierce, who's back in the starting lineup in Tommy Vivens' spot from the last game.
Okay, already, I think Canada's starting with a little bit less energy. It's a little bit hotter out there. Their style requires more energy. The U.S. now needs to possess the ball, change the point, what we used to call it when I coached the team, double change it. Change it to one side and change it all the way back to the other side. Break down the cohesiveness of their defense.
Wambach on the turn, finding Lilly. Quick left-footed pass, trying to find Milburn over the top, and it forced Switek to clear it out. A quick throw, and that should have been a card. Hooper just tossed Milbert down. And out it goes.
Two classic Charmaine Hooper fouls. The first one against Wambach was almost like a fist to the gut, and here you see her just taking Milbert down there right at the corner of the box.
Coming back the other way. Here's Sinclair to Kara Lang. Out wide against Fawcett. Joy will have to give up a corner kick. Lang wouldn't let her get good position. Third one for the Canadians. Only one for the USA today.
And I'm seeing Charmaine Hooper jog into the penalty area, which restores my confidence that Canada has somebody else that can take a corner kick.
We're about to find out. Lang is also up on this corner. Headed awkwardly, Timko's shot is blocked. Matheson didn't want to commit and commit. Instead, Milbert's flying, Wambach's ahead. Long ball over the top. Nonan has the legs to get there, and does. Well done by Nonan, and clears it out for a throw-in.
That's big-time defense by Nonan, and again, she hasn't been mentioned a lot, but she has been very, very solid for Canada.
Canada trying to play it up the wing for Latham. It goes out for a USA throw-in here in the 50th minute.
You can see Hooper, when she plays physically.
Sobrero's up.
That's her style. We'll see more of her playing that way throughout the game.
Off a deflection. Hooper wanted that to be cleared out instead of a corner. The look is at the referee's assistant to see what the call was going to be. And let's see what they do. It's going to be a throw-in deep. USA's throw. On the far side, Canada getting into the way of that. 1-1 game. And now the USA will have a better opportunity from the corner. Their second one. Ham is ready. Fawcett's up. So is Box. Wambach pushes up Redick as well. Only a few players back outside of the box for the USA. Struck with authority. Switek got caught. Fox! 2-1 USA!
Here's a beautiful corner kick by Mia Hamm to the back post, and this is picture book perfect by Shannon Fox. She gets up over her defender there, that's Nonan, gets up over top of her, and look at this, just with absolute presence, brings it down, heads it down from that height, puts it in the back of the net, and that's Nonan, or I'm sorry, Andrews, that she beat there on that header.
JP, you were right on. Switek's first two steps were forward, that put her out of the play. Throughout this game, the U.S. has been much better in their flank service, and that was an example of it. That was a very well-driven corner by Mia Hamm, by the way.
You can hear the sound of it coming.
Here it comes again. You can see her first two steps are forward. She can't recover then. Their service, their flank service has been so much better today than it has been against Germany.
Wambach in another collision there with Timko. USA bench celebrating. It goes back, Wendy, to what we were all talking about when this tournament began. Those goals off the set pieces. We see another one here.
Well, the U.S. just has so many great players in the air. Shannon Box plays that back post so well. We've seen her play it on free kicks, making the run to the back post, and on corner kicks as well.
Box's second goal of this World Cup. And fourth in her international career. Remember how she started? Goals in her first three international matches. First one in a USA women's national team uniform to ever do that. Here's Kiss with a free kick. The ball is cleared away. And Kiss will blast that one way off target.
When your shot goes for a throw-in, it's never really a good thing.
That is a club you do not want to be a member of. The shot for throw-in club.
Reddick lost the boot in the process. The shoe comes flying off. The ball comes up the other way. Milbritt on the run. Has Wambach, but Wambach was making a run down the middle. Switek will clear it, and Wambach's down again.
Hooper's claiming that it was a dive. Wambach's saying that she's pushing me over. The Australian referees have to sort that out.
On that far side, a battle for the ball. Results in a free kick. Tony, you talked at the top about how will the Australian referee call this game. You found out early.
Well, she's letting a lot go. I mean, it's a physical game. The U.S. has planned on it being a physical game. They've come and they've matched the physicality of the Canadians. But the Canadians, obviously, that plays into their style more readily.
Free kick coming up. Canadians on this free kick. That was sent way low and cleared away by Fawcett. Matheson tries to redirect it. Latham on the turn, tackled away. USA countering up for Wambach. And it comes back towards Switek. For more on the Canadians' physical style of play, let's go downstairs to Tisha Holt. Tish.
Yeah, Canada loves to play physical. That is their game. They believe this is to their advantage. They feel they can out-muscle and out-fight this U.S. team, and that's going to be how they win this game. JP?
We'll see if that continues. Tish with their physical play up top for sure, and Hooper in the back.
You know, a lot of the press, there's a Canadian writer that wrote about this matchup saying that the Canadians know that they believe that the U.S. hates to be muscled around, and that's what Tish is referring to, is the physicalness of these battles when they play each other.
Wambach's already said she loves that style of play, so not everybody.
Well, let's take a look at some of the physical play by Charmaine Hooper, who knows how to deal it out. I mean, these are tackles that she's going into and she's making statements on. She wants the ball, and anyone that's in her way is going to have to pay a price.
We saw several fouls there. I don't know how many of those were called, but few. Here's Timko clearing it away. Headed across. Matheson swept away. Bowdy's pass up. This is Mia. Try to get that. A Wambach. Switek came out and nearly paid a very steep price that she went into Wambach.
A good play by Switek. That's not an easy ball to come for, especially when you have Abby Wambach bearing down on you. But she came quickly, she came sharply, and she held on to it.
57th minute. Canada will have a throw in. That far wing. Lily out there defending. Canadians try to play it across, and they will get a throw in coming up. From a little bit deeper.
It's key now for the U.S. not to let Canada back in the game. The U.S., again, and I've said this over and over, they possess the ball, change the point, run the Canadians out defensively so they don't have their legs offensively.
And that was definitely working for him at the end of the first half. The front runners for Canada were absolutely exhausted, and that's going to be key for this U.S. team again, possessing, like you said, Tony. Keep the ball moving.
This ball is moving over the end line. It's going to be a goal kick. What we haven't seen so far from the Canadians this half, no Lang, no Sinclair, no Latham. And they were dominating to an extent in the first half. Remember all those shots that Lang had. So far, they've been unable to get involved. We'll see.
Well, I'm sure the coach Heinrichs and coach Palladino went into the locker room and said, defense, you need to be better, you need to be harder. They're getting too much from too little,
And I've seen that the U.S. defense respond to that.
Well, and I think one of the areas of the field that they have buttoned up on is that space that Shannon Box is now dominating again. She was letting Sinclair play out of that spot.
Wambach got an advantage call, trying to tuck it back for Milbrun. Some unselfish play for Wambach, who may have been able to create something on her own, but saw the cutting Milbrun deep.
It's a tough decision. It's a tough decision because you might be able to get the ball through here. We'll see it. It's very close to getting through, and if it gets through, Tiffany Milbert's going to get a great shot. Hooper gets her heel on it and deflects it out. So I think it's the right decision by Abby Wambach in that decision in that particular situation, but she could have probably also shot it.
We keep talking about Hooper, and even though she's played physical, I mean, who wouldn't want her on their team? Gifted player, can score goals, and had to go to the back because they needed help there. And she's played it well. So good for Charmaine Hooper, who still has some years left in her in this game. On the throw-in for the USA, Wambach byline. I thought that ball was out. Looked it from here. Tough angle for us, but Hooper clears out for a throw-in for the USA. Wambach, the leading goal scorer coming into this game for the USA with three. Had him in three straight games. Shut out against Germany. There's a ball played across. Foudy and Milbert were there, but it was sort of between them. Box will settle. She has the go-ahead goal.
See there, for me, it's a great opportunity for Box to possess the ball. Knock it into Joy Fawcett. Knock it into Kat Reddick. Get it back. Keep the ball. And rebuild rather than try a ball over the top.
Lily, nice ball to Foudy. A cutting ball, almost got through, but there was Hooper again.
And Hooper's really come up big on these last few attacks by the United States. This is a critical point in this match because if the U.S. gets another, it's going to be tougher for Canada to come back.
USA will have a throw-in coming up. Passes completed, about half of them for the USA are close to it in the attacking third.
That's not a bad statistic, and that means they're trying a lot of final passes, or they're trying a lot of passes leading up to final passes. That's important for them to possess the ball in that area of the field. I think they can improve on that a little bit, but that's still not a bad statistic.
When they went back and reviewed the semifinal match tape, they realized that the area of the field that they did not do a good job in was in the attacking third, taking care of the box, especially in the 18. They've done a better job of cleaning that up tonight.
Hooper, long left-footed ball. And that's intercepted. I can't recall a touch this half from Lang, Sinclair, or Latham. And we're 15 minutes in. Right side.
Play Joy. Pierce. Yes, that's it.
Touch back for Pierce. Intended for Foudy. Reddick with pressure there from Lang. Sobrero up the wing. Julie Foudy, Shannon Box. Quick touch, well done. Hand towards Lily's side. Wambach got it first. Schweitzer came out, got the ball, and gets the rest. Wambach's down, but right back up. She'll come.
This started because the U.S. was very patient coming out of the back, and it sprung a great attack. Wambach on the left side. Just gets a little bit away from her. She had Milbert there in the slot position, and Lily again at the top of the box. Wambach needs to make a better decision there.
I think she needs her first touch to be a cutback pass there. But that was a great piece of soccer by the USA, possessing it out of the back, then building through midfield, and then sending in a player in on goal. That's the way they need to play.
Abby Wambach went from a bubble player on this team a few months ago to a starter in the World Cup. Kat Reddick to Box, over to Kate Sobrero. USA leading Canada 2-1. This is the third place match. Canada's never gotten this far. The USA finished in third in 95 and won the other two World Cups. Right to Foudy in the right wing. Has Milbert with her. Foudy takes it into the middle. Lily back to Box. Box will switch it, but that's way behind. Bad ball that goes out. Bowen coming up for Canada. Tomorrow we'll be crowning a new champion at 12:30 Eastern on ABC Sports. It's the FIFA Women's World Cup Final. Germany versus Sweden. Both of these European powers seeking the first world championship in a women's game as the flag pops up on Wambach. Offside USA.
That's going to be a great game tomorrow, JP. There's contrasting styles. There's wonderful personalities, attacking personalities on both teams. Both teams have good goalkeepers. I mean, I'm expecting to see an epic World Cup final.
It's tomorrow on ABC Sports. Team Sweden taking on Germany, and Hanna Lundborg in there taking a look. They don't have to worry about playing a second game of a doubleheader today, so they can relax and enjoy this one. Tomorrow, they'll be playing. USA and Canada can be watching. Flags up on the opposite side of the Canadian, 64th minute. Fourth time they've been offside today.
At the top of the show, Tony, you mentioned that for Canada to be successful, their three front has got to be involved. In this second half, they just haven't been involved. And I look down there and I see Lang and I see Latham, and they look exhausted. And the U.S. defense is listening to you. Look at this possession that they're playing. They're really making these front runners have to chase, and it's exhausting them.
Right. Lang is not the same player. I think she ran herself out in the first half, which is, you know, something that you would expect from a 16-year-old.
Wambach played it across. You were saying before she only knows one pace, and maybe that was too much. Possession time, this is not a surprise with the USA having this much possession. Canada has not had high numbers this whole World Cup.
But where the U.S. is having possession now, I think, is important. They're back four, possessing the ball much better, which allows for good preparation into the midfield. And now, once they get the ball in the midfield, the U.S. midfield should be able to fry the Canadian midfield and start to get some players in behind the defense.
Nolan backing away as Lily takes the throw-in. The referee had to give her a warning. Long ball up. And when that missed Latham, there was no other support there for the Canadians. That was physical. And the foul was called. And finally a yellow card.
Ham goes up for this challenge here and gets a good shove, good elbow in the back from behind by Lang.
And that's just called consistent infringement. When the same player is fouled, it doesn't mean that Lang is fouling her all the time, but because she's being fouled consistently by the same team, eventually a card has to come out. That's good refereeing.
Canada have a lot of subs up right now. Fresh legs could be what's needed. Switek will grab that. 66th minute. USA 2, Canada 1 in the third place match. Canada was in 12th place in the last World Cup, so by far and away they're the most improved nation since the 99 World Cup. Long ball over the top, too far for Wambach, and Switek will let it go. It'll be a goal kick. Go-ahead goal in this game by Box. Lily scored first, and
here's Abby Wambach with all her contact.
Kat Rennick with it on the far side, and that ball is cleared out of play. Going to be a Canadian throw-in. Nonan intercepted on the wing. Early ball from Lily. Flag is up. Referee's not going to acknowledge that one. Waving it off instead. Matheson in the middle. Two more players down. Play continuing. Here's Canada with Timko. Brittany Timko will push it up. Intercepted. Here's Foudy. Milbert. Quick touches. Ham trying to go around Hooper, who brought her down. Mia knew the contact was coming.
And Hooper certainly wasn't going to let her make that touch around her and beat her.
That was a great little touch by Mia, because if she got around her, she was heading for goal.
Kat Rennick with two goals against North Korea sends this one forward. Switek's out. It's headed by Wambach. Wide. Well, somehow there was a touch there, apparently by Swiatek, because it's a corner.
Pat Reddick serves such a beautiful ball. Look at this ball dropping right into the mix there in an area where Abby Wambach is dangerous. Swiatek is completely committed out of the nets there. You could see her off to the left-hand side.
Cooper actually touched that one. 68th minute corner, USA. They scored a goal on the last one. Ham across. Swiatek, not a doubt. USA get it back. Milford floated it up. Bowdy's after it. Having a go. As Lilly is long and just wide.
Good counterattack. A good corner kick by the U.S. First, it hits off the crossbar. Somebody keeps it alive. I think Tiffany Milbert's ball here is a very good ball that almost finds Joy Fawcett, and Christine Lilly ends up getting a shot at goal.
69th minute, USA 2, Canada 1. And what can be the USA, for the USA, the last World Cup appearance for a lot of these players. Scoring chances plenty in this game. 32 in total.
What we're seeing the USA do on their attack is they're using that Swiatek aggressiveness, trying to get to every ball, and now she's coming for balls that she can't get to and getting herself in trouble, and almost the goal that led to that last corner kick.
You know, and I'd actually like to see the U.S. take it to the next level, and the player for the Canadian in the Canadian defense that's making all the plays of late has been Charmaine Hooper. So take a look up. They're bringing the balls out of the range of Swiatek, but Hooper, now they've got to be concerned about her because every ball is dropping in where she's making great defensive plays on them.
Yeah, they should be reading her a bit. Now, I don't expect to see her in defense too much longer. I think that Coach Pellerud has to get her into attack. As you pointed out, Wendy, the attack is sputtered here for Canada.
Sobrero will intercept this. Hooper, by the way, was also on that all-star team that you guys talked about at the beginning of this match, playing in a position where she's not played before, at the back.
No, she's just a good soccer player.
Again, the no foul continues to be the norm here. A lot is being let go on both sides. That was a difficult ball and a careless ball back, but Canada cannot capitalize. Here's Nonan. Matheson. Kiss to the right. Nonan advances. Sherolta Nonan cuts it back. Floats it up there. Knocked away. It's intended for Latham. USA with it. Pass for Wambach. Timko got her. Lang. Wambach's been off of her feet as much, it seems, as she's been on her feet today. I know that's an exaggeration, but she's been hit a lot. And now the referee will stop play again and call that foul against the USA.
Wambach has had a tough day. It's been physical all over the field for her, not only with their own teammates there with Carlo, but going in on the goalkeeper, going up against Charmaine Hooper. Just time and time again, she's been on the other end of these physical battles going down. One thing I'm noticing is she might be able to help herself out a little bit, especially checking back to balls, just making the run a little bit sooner to control her defender that coming on her. That I think she might be getting a little bit fatigued.
That's a good point. Control your defender so that she can't whack you, and then you can move off to receive the ball.
Hooper's up on this free kick that Kiss will take. She floats it up there. Knotted down. USA can't clear out. Sinclair didn't hit it well. Flag is up on Canada. Had Sinclair been able to come around on that shot, who knows what could have happened. It could have been a 2-2 game.
Well, right now, that's the only way I see Canada getting back into this game is off a set piece. I do think that they're going to need to get Charmaine Hooper up front, because right now the Canadian three front is not working. They've run themselves out a bit here. You're going to need an infusion. What better player to bring forward than Charmaine Hooper?
Milbred. Playing it across. Sobrero. Kate will get it back and will hold. Now the long ball. Out wide. Lilly for Milbred. The shot deflected off the post. And then Swiatek stopped that. Tiffany Milbred robbed of a goal.
But I couldn't tell if Swiatek got a little piece of that or not. But what a great attack again by the U.S. That was a ball over the top by Sobrero. And then Tiffany Milgren knows what to do when she's in the penalty area.
Kate Sobrero served a beautiful ball in there. Look at Lily's one quick touch there. Milgren goes near post, hits the post, tries to follow up on a second time there. She had beaten Swiatek to that near post, but just couldn't tuck it quite inside. It was a great attack by the United States.
They could have used an insurance goal, would have given them a two-goal lead right now. As long as Canada keeps it a one-goal game, they've got a shot.
Well, Canada has to do something. Either it has to come off the bench, and my suggestion would be bring another defender in and get Charmaine Hooper up in front of the goal somewhere, either coming out of attacking midfield or as one of the front runners.
This one out again for a throw-in. Road trip with Team USA is coming up right after the game. If you wonder what it's like to be on the national team, you're going to find out. It's your view behind the scenes. They got the charter during this World Cup 2003. Out for a corner where Canada can be very dangerous. It's their fourth one.
Looks like Cooper's going to go over and take it. And again, she's bending these balls right into the face of the goal, dropping them inside the six.
Still bad decision, in my view. She needs to be in the penalty area. She just has a knack. When the ball is loose in the penalty area, she just seems to get her foot on it and get a shot on goal. She's done that for the U.S. a number of times.
Ready for the corner. They'll play it short for the first time. Kiss will play it across. It deflects the header off the post. Oh, they caught the USA there. But Canada could not score. The USA was not expecting that short corner and had a tough time adjusting to the way that ball was moving. Well done by Canada, except for that last finish where they were just unlucky.
Tony mentioned that the place that Canada's dangerous is on set pieces. Exactly what we just saw.
I like that look.
Let's see if Bry gets a touch to this. No, it's over her. It hits off the crossbar. Great set piece by Canada that just didn't work out for them, but that's where they're going to be most dangerous.
Coming back on the left. Latham. Christine Latham, a quiet second half. The same with her other strikers. Sinclair and Lang, and Boston helped to win it. Wambach laid it off. Timko's got it. Puts it back up. Knocked it away to Box. 76th minute. USA leading Canada 2-1. Box for the go-ahead goal. Lily also scored for the USA. Sinclair for Canada. Wambach got nailed by Hooper. Finally, yellow card. And it could have been a yellow for that or persistent infringement as well. Take your pick. The 76th minute. But full credit to Charmaine Hooper, the way she's played. She's been a leader out there. Played the game physically. You know she wants to win it, maybe more than anyone else on that Canadian squad. Free kick for Mia Hamm. On the referee's whistle, she'll float it up. Wambach was looking, double-teamed. Matheson heads it away. Coming back for it was Lang, and now the Canadians clear it out. Couple of fakes there, and then Reddick plays it smart to keep possession rather than force a bad ball. Bowdy in a 2-1 USA lead. Sent it over, the flag went up again, but Canada intercepts. Kiss will take it. This ball goes out of play. Throw in for Canada. Kylie Bivens is up on the USA bench. So, USA, once they put her in, would still have one more sub to make if they want to. Lang. That was a good job by Lang, but equally well done by Sobrero to give him the throw-in, but she didn't let Lang get behind her. And the substitution is happening right now. Julie Foudy's number is up. And Julie will get some ovation here in what should be her last World Cup appearance.
Bivens will give them a little bit more defensive presence. She'll probably sit in with Fox, so you'll see two holding midfielders, and she'll try to possess from that position.
Fresh legs here could be important as well for the USA.
I was noticing something from up here. Sobrero actually thought that Bivens was coming in for her, and I've watched her a couple times recently. She looks a bit gassed out there. She's leaning over and putting her hands on her knees. We'll have to keep an eye on her.
Actually, I thought that was a sub, too.
Julie Foudy's day is done. As we mentioned, this is really it in terms of the 91ers. The only player that some people think that might still be around in the next World Cup might be Christine Lilly, but my gut feeling says they'll all go out together. The next World Cup is 4 years away. Of course, they've got the Olympics to worry about next summer. Here's Milbert on the run. Blocked off the face of Charmaine Hooper. She went after it hard and helps Canada to get possession back for Timko.
You know, JP, with Brandy not only playing a half of a game in this World Cup, you got to wonder if whether she's not going to try and hang in there and play through another World Cup. Their teammates say she'll play till her legs fall.
I know. 4 years is such a long way. Got to feel sorry for Brandi Chastain. Game one gets hurt, and I think in the Germany game is where you really saw the USA miss her. Not so much in the previous games where they maybe didn't need that kind of help, but against Germany, she was needed. Broken right foot in game one took her out of this World Cup. And she's been on the bench encouraging. She was so good after the loss too to Germany, consoling players. Free kick for Timko and Canada, who have not used the sub. Matheson broken up. Fox with it. 80th minute. Milbert. Touched out.
The U.S. defense have been so much better at winning first and second balls in this half, and that's really been the difference. The only way Canada can get back in is through a set piece. I don't see them building something now that would end up with a shot on goal.
I also think, Tony, that their possession, their focus on possessing the ball brought their confidence back. You know, they never did that in the first half, and they were under pressure by Canada early on in the match, and they never settled down and got any type of touches that would give them confidence.
Here's a ball played up toward Milbert. It's loose. Milbert shot. Milbert with a goal.
Milbert, look at Milbert taking her first shot, sticks with it, and absolutely roofs it. Look at that ball. That hits the roof of the net. Kind of felt like Milbert was going to get one. She was putting a lot of pressure on Canada right around the face of the goal. Look at that. That's a great angle of that shot. Left-footed, roofs it.
Well, great transition. Tiffany and Mia played together for many years. As soon as that ball was a call to foul, Mia looked up. Tiffany saw her. Sprinted behind the defense, and the rest was all Tiffany Milbert back of the net.
Tiffany's one goal away from 100. The USA, meanwhile, in the box goal, we neglected to tell you, got their 1,000th goal in international play. So that one gives the USA the insurance goal that they were looking for, and you would think would be enough for them on this day. Up 3-1 with about 9 minutes and stoppage time left. Nonan sends it wide of her Atlanta beat teammate, Brianna Scurry. And on the bench, Isabelle Morneau, maybe Canada's first sub. As we're in the 82nd minute.
Well, it's got to be a defensive sub to get Hooper forward.
We also saw Shannon McMillan on the sideline, so she's ready to come in as well. Down by Box to the right side where Kylie Bivens takes it over. She came in for Foudy up for Wambach. Shannon Box back to Bivens. Two surprise players in this World Cup that they were even named to the team going back months ago. No one expected that.
Box is named to the first 11.
Yes.
In the World Cup.
That's a great story. When Erin Heifetz told her about it, she just kept saying, come on now, come on. She's like, are you serious? Are you serious? Must have said it like five times. She was just so excited.
Aaron Heifetz, press officer for the USA national team. So there's McMillan to the right, Morneau to the left. We're told that Sobrero's coming out. Here's Pierce playing it back. Scurry. Gave that ball away. Fox. Ham. Going long. And the offside flag goes up. And tomorrow will be the title game. We'll crown a champion. Germany looking on. Will they be the next champions of this major event? Germany and Sweden tomorrow, 12:30 Eastern Time on ABC Sports. Birgit Prinz has scored a goal in every game. She's looking like the Golden Boot winner with 7 goals. Prinz in the back row looking on.
Is it happening? Maren Meinert and Birgit Prinz, or Victoria Svensson and Hannah Lundberg tomorrow? That'll be a story.
Two great duos certainly to watch. The hand is from McMillan.
Now, Tiffany was just called offside, but what Tiffany brings the U.S., Tiffany Milbritt, is she always tries to get behind the defense, and she stretches defenses that way.
Long ball the other way. Hooper. Now Hooper's up. This one's blocked. And the ball will be cleared out. So finally, Charmaine Hooper will be playing up top with Morneau playing at the back. Evan Pellerud has decided to go up with Hooper. It's a bit late, but if they could score one quick, Canada could have some life.
I think you're right, JP. I would have made the move when it was 2-1.
Morneau floats that up. Scurry comes out. Makes the play. 85th minute, some of these players in the USA national team playing in their final World Cup game after all these years, in their fourth World Cup, many of them. Here's McMillan on the run. Wide on Morneau, the cross inside is blocked. McMillan hangs in there, and now the ball comes to Isabelle Morneau. Up for Hooper, the flick on was intended for Latham, but those front runners have struggled. All the energy they used in the first half apparently has taken its toll here. Canada's had only a couple of shots in the second half.
You know, JP, I really think it's been the play of the veterans that has carried this U.S. squad. Mia Hamm getting an assist on a corner kick to Box, and then, of course, her quick restart. Lily scoring a goal, her quick restart to Milbritt. Had a really nice game for the United States in a position that she probably doesn't necessarily prefer. She'd probably rather be up top, but she played in that attacking center midfield position very nicely today.
Milbritt will hold it. Back for McMillan. The Box pass. Ham. Touch outside to Tiffany Milbritt. Running at Morneau. Towards the byline. Trying to keep her feet. Who touched the last corner kick, says the referee's assistant.
And that's her best quality, running at defenders. It's terrifying for a defender when you see Tiffany Milbritt start to go into gears that very few players have.
Has that great first gear that we all talk about, the quick first steps. Fourth quarter of the day for the USA. 87th minute, they'll take their time on this. Short corner, McMillan, that keeps possession. Headed up by Fawcett, and it goes out for a Canadian goal kick. Oh. 87th minute, it's all about the veterans today. Wendy and Tony talking about them now. Tisha Hope gets the chance. Tish.
These veteran players, I've played with these guys for a few years, and I'll tell you what, they really set the tone for the U.S. as far as everything that goes on the field and off the field. They're tremendous players. They train harder than anyone, and they're great people. They'll stay and do media after they lose. You know, they lost against Germany. Foudy was the last person to leave, you know, doing interviews. So, you know, they take care of their fans. They take care of the media. They're just great people, and it's great to see them out here. I think it'll be a pretty emotional ending here today for these veterans.
I'm sure it will, Tish. Thanks. Long ball played up. What did you call them, Wendy, at the start of the show? The kind of ladies? Special, marvelous. You had
some. Well, I just was saying that they're probably, you know, it's a handful of the most amazing women in sports.
There you go.
They'll be remembered that way for years and years.
And this is not just for the USA. They've represented
soccer and women's athletics worldwide and are known worldwide.
Fox will keep it alive to McMillan in the dying moments. That ball nearly made it. Nearly made it. Good effort from Shannon McMillan.
Shannon McMillan getting in on this right side here. Was it a cross? Was it a shot? Either way, it was pretty dangerous. It's good to see Shannon McMillan out there getting some quality touches on the ball.
Depends who asks you. If the coach asks you, you always say it was a shot.
We're going to see Lang coming out, and we look forward to watching her progress. We mentioned before, she's 16. She turned 17 in about a week's time, but still growing in this game.
Well, she had a great first half and an equally unimpressive second half. And I just think she ran herself out in the first half.
And that's something that she'll learn over time?
That's consistency and that's youth. And she's got a great future ahead of her.
Rianne Wilkinson takes her spot out there in the 89th minute. Box up from Wambach. Controlled now by the USA. And they'll swing it wide towards McMillan. Shannon McMillan will carry it. Cannon have another sub getting ready to come on. Carmelita Moscato. McMillan doing some work there, but can't get around Matheson. It's going to belong to Canada after all that.
Could have been called either way. But, you know, as I'm watching Shannon McMillan out here, you know, taking on the Canadian defender, and the Canadian defender goes down on the ground, it technically should be a free kick to the USA, but as I'm watching Shannon out here, I'm saying, wouldn't she have been a great sub in the Germany game? And I just was wondering if maybe her knee had swelled up a little bit, or she just wasn't mentally ready to play in that level of match.
Well, I think that's a good point to bring up, Tony, and a good one to definitely that people can debate. And I thought a lot about that. You know, as far as like maybe emotionally, she wasn't quite back. You know, she got back so quickly, and I remember Hege Riise from Norway. She really didn't contribute for that squad. They picked her because she kind of had to pick her as one of the last players because she's been around forever, and a sub off the bench, you know, what better person to have. But, you know, you can debate that for sure, whether or not Shannon was ready enough to be selected to this World Cup squad. It's really tough to say.
The one thing that the USA is hoping for is that Shannon will be there for the Olympics, where she'll have a lot more time, certainly, to get ready for it.
Well, even with her injury, I think she was one of the leading scorers this year.
Yes.
For the USA.
This ball headed away. In the meantime, Canada made their final sub. We've got 3 minutes of stoppage time. Neal came out and Moscato came in. Here's a USA throw in from Pierce. Foul right away by Moscato. USA will have a free kick, but Shannon McMillan's not getting up quickly. Now she's up as Ham gets ready for the free kick. We're in stoppage time, 3 minutes added on in this third place match. Ham strikes it up. Wambach kept it going. Lily Milbert blocked. Morneau stopping that.
What a great ball by Christine Lilly to put that in front and give Tiffany Milbert a shot at it.
On the far side, that's a long run for Canada. It's going to go out of play. Wilkinson couldn't get to it. We're about halfway done with stoppage time. Some of the veterans, some of the young players on this USA squad. Some will be on the Olympic team, obviously, and obviously others won't be. Well, time for that.
JP, there's players like Charmaine Hooper. Is this her last World Cup? Julie Foudy, Christine Lilly, Joy Fawcett, and the 91ers. Is this their last World Cup? You can imagine how emotional it is for them they walk off the field today.
And you'll probably see that in their reaction to the crowd here. Fox will send it wide. Lilly's open. Takes it in, the cross, headed straight up, headed away by Canada. Box drives it back, but it's wide. And we're down a seconds left in this third place match. Canucks will get credit for the game-winning goal. The insurance goal was by Milbert. The Canadians will be back. They've got some good young players, especially up top. So I think the best is still yet to come for Canada, who will end up in fourth place in this tournament after finishing 12th in the last one.
Impressive tournament for Canada. What they need to do now is become a better soccer team. They certainly have fighting power. They just need to become better soccer players, and that will happen.
Lilly sends it forward in the closing seconds. Quick shot wide of Switek. Seconds left. Waiting for the final whistle as the referee checks out the watch. Morneau. Wambach. That's it. USA wins the third place match in a final World Cup game for many of these players. Christy Lilly, the only one that we think might have a shot at playing in the next World Cup. Others could play if they wanted to, but we could be seeing the last of the collection of the 91ers today in a World Cup anyway. For some, the Olympics will be their next goal, and the goal would obviously be to get the gold medal. USA defeated Canada. It's a 3-1 final. They win the third place match. Canada finishes in fourth. ABC and ESPN, official broadcast partners of the FIFA World Cup and Major League Soccer.
You saw your organization's color needs increasing. You knew that adding more single-function color laser printers wasn't going to cut the mustard. You knew it was time to turn to Canon for its color solutions. Now, my friend, it's time to reap the rewards.
Swim class, $60. Hockey camp, $340. Driving lessons, $250. Being able to let go. Being able to let go. Priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For parents everywhere, there's MasterCard.
What are you talking about?
If we get injured in this work, we're covered for things like lost pay and other expenses with this.
With what?
Plus they pay you cash. Great, huh?
Who does?
Aflac. Aflac. Ask about it at work.
Benny Wallace. Wrong direction, bro.
Some other time.
Let me tell you something. ESPN NBA basketball. I've lived the 24/7 mode, and I've achieved the ISO motion. Like this, like that, like this. Rated everyone.
Today, for 12 big hours at Fingers, save 50% in every department, no exceptions. Plus, you pay nothing for one full year. No down payment, no monthly payment, no interest. Discover a whole new world of savings during Fingers Columbus Day sale. Save 50% throughout Fingers' $30 million selection. Every department, no exceptions. Half off bedrooms, living rooms, dining rooms, kids' furniture, leather. Pay nothing for one full year. The Columbus Day sale is at your Fingers.
Are you ready for some football? High impact, high energy, high school football. We're talking Texas tradition. Houston High School End Zone, brought to you in part by Olshan. If you don't need us today, we'll be here tomorrow. And your Texas Chevy dealers. Chevy, drive in Texas. Watch Houston's best half-hour action-packed sports show, Houston High School End Zone. Tonight at 10 p.m. on News 24 Houston, Time Warner Cable, Channel 24.
Well, a lot of the USA veterans know this is their last World Cup, and the fans in attendance seem to know it as well. A tremendous ovation at the end of this match as the USA goes out in style with a win over Canada Final score is 3-1. Hope you enjoyed this one today from Carson, California, as the USA wins 3-1. Up next on ESPN2, Road Trip with Team USA. And then tomorrow at 12:30 on ABC, join us for the finals, Germany, Sweden. Final score again, USA wins today. See you tomorrow.
Road trip so far.
Hello.
Let me think. We've been to so many places you kind of forget.
I don't remember yesterday. Charlottesville was a great time for us to come together as a team. Then we moved up to D.C., made it through the hurricane.
Wind is right now about 30 miles per hour. I have 1 inch of rain.
And then played against Sweden, did well, had a great crowd.
And the USA come away with a victory in game one.
Brandy getting hurt has been difficult, but Kat stepped in, did a great job.
Still surreal at moments. You know, sometimes I'm pinching myself. I'm like, was that really Joy Fox at the time?
We bust to Philly and had a great stint there.
Best I've ever had.
On the shot, and a goal. USA come away with a victory, 5-0.
And we hopped on an incredible chartered plane. You feel like a rock star.
This is awesome! So we can get off on the way. Columbus, Ohio.
That is it. USA with the game and the group.
Life is still good. We get to come to New England and play the number two team in the world.
Boston, here we come.
World Cup in 99 was
fantastic,
incredible.
Woo.
The thrill of a lifetime. But that was 4 years ago.
Ancient history.
So last century. That was then.
This is us!
To win the World Cup again, it's going to take
sweat, trust, laughter,
focus,
dancing,
teamwork,
20 players,
and one goal.
It's going to take a World Cup road trip.
Road trip!
10 cities,
7 weeks,
6 games.
Taking a road trip.
I got shotgun.
Road trip!
Road trip! Road trip!
Road trip!
Road trip! Road trip! Road trip! Road trip!
Are we there yet?
There are people dying, so it's time to lend a hand.
Like, oh my God.
The greatest gift of all.
Wow, 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 wow.
We are the world.
All the world.
We are children.
All the children. Obviously, what we do on the field is the experience and the reason why we're doing this, but I think we get more from off-the-field stuff.
Would you like to have your face lifted?
Yes, please. From passing books from teammate to teammate, to doing crosswords with your teammates, to talking about the possibilities of winning a World Cup.
Yeah, we just finished our first round against North Korea today. We won 3-0.
Woo!
Yay! Now we're moving on. Flying into Providence, but we're playing at Foxborough, and we get to play Norway.
These little things, the intangible things, you can't put your finger on, you can't put a price on, and you definitely can't reenact.
My brother sent me this Iraqi flag here that his entire platoon signed, made it out to the U.S. Women's National Team, and then from the Rat Bastard Platoon of the 101st Airborne Division Air Assault. My little brother's been my biggest fan ever since I began playing, so for him not to be a part of this World Cup has been difficult, but I know he's there in spirit, and he's wishing us the best.
this Memorial Boulevard right here?
No, I just turn and get to the time of here by the light. I'll take that right, that fits all the way there.
And that's a good scenic run?
Oh, yeah.
That's the last time!
You know, after you play a game like last night and you travel, you want to get the blood flowing. And nothing heavy. You don't necessarily need to be doing a lot of cutting. Just sweating a little bit, getting a stretch in. And
what a day this is!
Trying to kind of flush it out. A nice easy light day.
Let's go to the Capitol building, whatever that is.
This is the stage of you win or you go home, and so we are entirely focused on, you know, what we need to do against Norway and how we can keep moving forward.
Take care of yourself. We only got 2 days.
Pause on three. 1, 2, 3.
Pause.
Road trip with Team USA, made possible by NikeSoccer.com.
Duramax bulb lasts longer. 1 year life. Duramax. Light bulbs that last. From Philips.
Do you know who I am?
How about me?
Or me. I'm a gymnast. I'm a point guard. And an honor student.
I'm going to be a pediatrician.
Research proves that girls who participate in sports are more likely to be successful in life. The Women's Sports Foundation provides programs, grants, and scholarships so all women can excel, no matter what the field.
So if you don't know who I am, you will.
Get to know the Women's Sports Foundation.
I travel with a stack of papers to every event, everything that I think we could need. Every single day, I'll go through probably about 75 to 100 quotes to try to find that one that I think fits our team at that moment. I'll get up, half an hour before the players are out of their room or I think the first people are going to be awake, and just go up and down the halls and slip that piece of paper under everybody's door. The essential conditions of everything you do must be choice, love, passion.
Nadia Boulanger.
Okay, we've got one opponent in front of us and one team that stands in the way. For those of you that were there in 2000, and for those of you that were there in 95, don't ever forget, this is the country that ripped your heart out and threw it on the ground.
Norway is truly the biggest rival we've ever had. Norway, I think, is possibly the only team that has a winning record against us. Either us or Norway has won every major championship, whether it be Olympics or World Cup.
They're talented. Their mentality is one of the strongest in the world. They find ways to win. And, you know, that's why, you know, you don't really like to see them.
I think in terms of rivalry, Norway brings out maybe the best in our team, and I can guarantee you that everybody's going to step on the field ready tomorrow.
Fans sent me a newspaper clipping from the 2000 Olympics, and it's me holding my head after we had just lost to Norway. This is it says gold to Norway, silver to us. We call it white gold. And I can remember that feeling of standing on the field. And I remember the pose, actually, standing on the field after we lost to Norway in the gold medal game. and the feeling and the anger and, you know, wanting it back and wanting the chance again. And we have the chance again right now. I hate that feeling. I don't want that feeling. I don't. We're going to do everything we can not to have it. I just have something that I want to share with you guys. Just something I put together. Now, remember, I'm not a poet. So in 1991, we put on our sweats of pink, green, and white, traveling to China, prepared for a fight, trying to find a place in the game where we could etch our name. And we did just that, as a matter of fact. 95 in Sweden didn't turn out the same. A team from Norway was to blame. And I am here to say we will never forget that day.
We are underway from Foxborough.
Now it's time for us to meet our so-called nemesis.
Whoa! These games are always so physical with Norway. Both teams go all out.
Who in the world gets to have as much fun as this?
The shot by Redick was over the bar.
This is not our last.
Lilly runs around her.
This is way too much of a blast.
Here's the long ball up.
There's more to come of this World Cup glory.
That's it. Norway's going home. USA wins.
But everyone will have to wait till morn to read the story.
The new Impala SS. With one nasty supercharged engine. When you need the power, or not, we'll be there. Chevy.
Chevy Impala, with available OnStar.
Is it or is it not true that you kicked and pummeled the plaintiff in the plain view of over 60,000 witnesses?
It's true.
And what did you and your malicious co-conspirators do next?
We cheered.
As this poor, battered soul lay, defenseless and deflated.
You didn't tell me you cheered.
Bud Light, proud sponsor of the U.S. Women's National Team in the FIFA Women's World Cup.
We're toast.
390-pound phenom Bob the Beast Sapp. Hard-hitting KO champion Carter Williams. ESPN Pay-Per-View presents K1's Final Elimination Saturday, October 11th. To order, call your cable company, DirecTV, or Dish Network.
This training officer gives good advice.
Stay away from women you meet while in uniform.
We are ladies.
But when this trainee ignores it, he's in for the surprise of his life.
When we kissed, I wasn't the only guy who got excited.
A new 10-8, Officers on Duty, followed by Alias, ABC Sunday.
For your next construction job, think Bobcat, the industry standard. Bobcat of Houston sells and rents quality, versatile equipment, but we also offer concrete hand tools for flat work, other specialty tools, parts, attachments, accessories, and of course, our factory-trained technicians. Other dealers may sell Multi-Quip, but we are the authorized repair facility. That means we keep you working. Call or come by and let's talk about your next job. So get the advantage, the Bobcat of Houston advantage.
2004 Chevy Silverado with available power packs. Take a look at how the savings stack up. Start with the Texas Edition Power Pack and save $1,000. Add the Light Duty Power Pack and save another $1,000. Plus, the Safe and Sound Power Pack saves you another grand. Best of all, combine Power Pack savings with cash back for a total value of $5,500. Silverado with available power packs now at your Texas Chevy dealer. Chevy, drive in Texas.
Thoughts. You took on one of the best teams in the world last night. You took them on, and in every facet, you beat them. You know what is unimaginable? They had one shot on goal.
Yeah!
Let's get on our charter plane. Let's enjoy this.
Hello! Old lady trying to go up the stairs again.
And when we get off the plane, it's a new challenge in front of us with one opponent on our mind.
Going to Portland.
We get to Portland, it's a new focus.
Always dream and shoot higher than you know how to. Don't bother just to be better than your contemporaries or predecessors. Try to be better than yourself. William Faulkner.
Okay, come in a little closer. In my estimation, this is the time of a tournament that the United States gets better, because pressure is a privilege. We have a long history against Germany. I mean, they're a great tactical team. They play hard, yet they play smart. So I like this matchup. I think it is going to be a great game.
You are funny.
Unless there's divine intervention, and I'm a realist, I just don't, you know, I'm very optimistic, but, you know, sometimes you have to come to terms with what's really happening. It's still broken. I think I'm looking towards the 12th. I have confidence in these guys anyway, so we'll be playing in that game.
Anyone that wants to shower can shower in here. And then we've got two groups, one going back to the hotel and one going shopping. Let's get a hand of how many are doing
bus shopping.
Going shopping,
all that gear.
Come on, you and take five.
Six, seven.
All right, here's the deal. We've been traveling together for, what, 3 weeks now?
Yeah.
And we've been wearing the same set the whole time, okay? So we are going to search for the outfit that we would like to wear after the World Cup.
Here at Chipotle, best creators around. As you can see, this is a very short line.
I got a chicken burrito. It's the only kind you get. Chicken burrito, guacamole, and hot sauce on the side.
When you have a nice derriere, you can't fit into outfits per se like this, because it wouldn't fit over that.
This is hard work. This is my dream come true. I know, I can't believe we're working here right now. She goes to Chipotle every day.
Yeah, wouldn't be caught dead on the street.
Never.
Look right now. Hi, Maiden.
Oh, okay.
appears the FIFA World Cup needs a communications network that handles anything
you throw
at it. Where do you find a network like that? In the state of Avaya. We built a network that juggles converged voice and data and thousands of IP calls a day. That's why the world's largest sporting event called on Avaya Global Services again. We shoot. We score. You win. Reach Avaya, a higher plane of communication.
Tradition.
A look on the other guy's face.
To be my own Manning.
Being a woman.
Because last year, I couldn't.
Millions of little girls.
Every athlete is fueled by something.
Do you know who I am?
How about me?
Or me. I'm a gymnast. I'm a point guard and an honor student.
I'm going to be a pediatrician.
Research proves that girls who participate in sports are more likely to be successful in life. The Women's Sports Foundation provides programs, grants, and scholarships so all women can excel, no matter what the field.
So if you don't know who I am, you will.
Get to know the Women's Sports Foundation.
Coming up on SportsCenter, the Marlins need a big game from their best rookie. An epic tangle in Tallahassee, Miami, Florida State. And we'll blitz around the NFL. SportsCenter, 6 Eastern on ESPN2.
Road Trip with Team USA. Made possible by NikeSoccer.com.
The heat is on the Red Sox. Sure, all the pressure's on the Red Sox tonight. They have to win.
We gotta give Mia support.
We got our rally caps on. She needs support.
We are Red Sox fans, and we love Mia. Mia loves Nomar, so we love Nomar, too. We all get together, cheer Nomar and the Red Sox on. It's fun.
Oh, boy. Is zipper.
This when you start standing up.
He is one.
Big fly. Gets it high in the air, deep to center. Burns is back to the running track at the wall. It's gone! And the Red Sox have stayed alive with a win in the 11th.
This is actually from Sidney Carlo's brother, and I think many of you, all of you, have seen the Iraqi flag that his, is it First Airborne?
Mm-hmm.
Sent and signed to everybody, and I'm just starting midway through the email. Cindy, I'm so proud of you. It's so cool to be able to say, yeah, my sister plays on the U.S. national team. I don't know if the American flag is on your uniform like it is ours, but on ours, the blue section with the stars in it is in the upper right-hand corner instead of the upper left. It is sewed on our uniforms that way to symbolize the flag bearer and the soldiers running toward the battle. Whereas most people run away from it, it is people like you and your fellow teammates that run towards it. You're an attacking midfielder on the greatest team on earth. I wish you the best of luck, Godspeed, or Allah speed, and good hunting. Love, little Larry.
Okay, let's get started. How to beat Germany. Let me just tell you something. I love the fact that the media is making a big deal of how many goals they've scored. Because I love being underestimated. And I'll tell you what, I think the media, I think the Germans, I think the German camp is underestimating the power of the United States attack. And I hope they're the victims of their own media. And that is believing that the games they play compared to the games we play have prepared them. If we come prepared, we bring our A game and we get after them with a little in-your-face attacking the American way. Let's go at them. Let's go at them. Every game has a story. And the game against Germany was a story in itself.
Gareth Freckus has scored the goal. Germany has the lead over the United States. The first time the USA has trailed in this World Cup.
The first thought I had was, there's plenty of time. We got 75 minutes. There's plenty of time.
Carlo toe poking it. Ham makes a run. The shot's blocked.
There was something missing the whole game.
Ham breaks in. Keeper made the save.
The goalkeeper just kept getting in the way.
Lombok on the left side, get it on one defender, cannot get around a second one.
You know, we were one touch away from scoring a goal.
Prinz, open player, man-mighted with a goal!
When you saw that ball go in, you just wanted to drop down on your knees and start crying right there.
A two-goal lead now for Germany.
What struck me was how silent it was. You could actually hear what the Germans were saying.
Germany gets their third goal! Game over! Germany is going to the final, and the USA are eliminated from the World Cup.
You're thinking to yourself, there's no way this can be happening. It's not over. I looked at Mia, and I looked at Lil, and then Brady came up and gave me a hug. That was when it really hit me hard.
I know, it didn't end up the way we wanted it to.
Girls. I think yesterday truly was a day where we needed to be real, we needed to be ourselves, authentically who we were yesterday. When you're an athlete and you stick it out there as often as we stick it out there, every now and then you don't win the way you want. I've been knocked down in my life. There's no question. And it hurts, but I come fighting back even more determined. Time for everybody to come together even closer. We're down and out right now, but we're bouncing up. Jewel?
You know, everyone keeps saying, you know, I want to rewind the tape. I want another chance. I want to go back. But don't ever think I want to just forget about it. You know, I don't want to go back to that day. I don't want to remember it. Because remembering and knowing and learning from it is what is going to make us stronger. We have 10 months before the next Olympics. So when you're out there training every day for the next 10 months, remember it. Remember how it feels. Because we are good enough. We are good enough to be on that gold medal podium. And we know it. Every single person here knows it. So let's use the next 10 months to show the world how good we are.
Goodbye! We love you!
What lies behind you and what lies before you are tiny matters compared to what lies within you.
Emerson.
This is SportsCenter.
It's Separation Saturday. Miami, Florida State. The underdog Hurricanes try to blow past the Seminoles. Texas, Oklahoma. Will the Sooners hook another Red River Shootout?
Auburn, Arkansas. The Tigers are on the prowl for an upset in Fayetteville. Baseball's best playoffs in years continue in South Florida. In desperate need of a win, the Marlins turn to the D train to derail the Cubs. Will Peyton's play still be unbeaten come Sunday? Dallas leans on Quincy's feet to avoid the blitzing Eagles, while an angry Bucks defense seeks to redeem itself after last week's debacle. Watch out now. SportsCenter is next.
On Separation Saturday, we have separated from ESPN 1. Welcome to Sports Center on ESPN 2. Jay Harris alongside Kevin Frazier.
And we start this party with one of college football's greatest rivalries, Florida State and Miami. And for the first time since 1992, both teams entered the game in the top five. So the folks at Doak Walker all fired up, all hyped up.